Good evening and welcome to Arizona Horizon. I'm Ted Simons. A deal to buy the Phoenix Coyotes fell through last week, but hockey officials and the city of Glendale are still looking for ways to keep the team in town. Joining us now is the mayor of Glendale, Jerry Weiers. Good to have you here, Mayor.
Well, thanks for having me.
Were you surprised that the Jamison Group missed the deadline?
You know, I actually wasn't surprised. I've been in sales a good portion of my life. Have owned several businesses, and you get to where you read body language and things like that, and just a lot of hearsay from a lot of outsiders that tell you things they believe. I wasn't surprised. I sort of expected it, but at the same time, we had given our word. The city of Glendale, the previous council, made a deal, and we kept our word. Unfortunately, he didn't make it happen, or fortunately, however things play out. But right now, I see some great opportunities for us, and hopefully we'll be able to take advantage of that.
I want to talk about that in a second here, but what do you know and what can you say about why the group failed? I mean, this has been a year in the making, and it just was stretched to the last second, then nothing.
Well, again, I don't know his contacts. He never did divulge that. I think it really comes down to a lot of different factors. One is the team hasn't had the greatest record. I mean, last year was a great season for them, and hopefully they could continue that. But then they go into a strike, mm-hmm. and so it seems like it's been one problem after another in lots of different areas. A recession hasn't helped any of us out. And to find a buyer and find the people that will come to the games consistently and businesses that want to sponsor, advertise and things like that, it's just been a really tough fight for everybody. Obviously, we gain if we can come up and figure out a way to keep the team in Glendale, but it has to be something that makes sense. It can't be at all costs. It has to be something that makes sense for our city and obviously our citizens.
Now, the Coyotes will stay in Glendale for the rest of this season, as far as you know?
That's correct.
Okay, and then once the season is over, who knows?
We're trying real hard to keep them.
Yeah. The city released a statement after this was announced that, quote, seeking direction from city council on how to move forward. What does that mean?
Well, we have four new members, obviously. Today makes day 21, not that I'm counting. Day 21 for me as the mayor of Glendale. And, again, I have to try to represent the entire city. The three new council members, along with myself, had a different version on what the previous council had taken. That's not to say the previous council was wrong or that we're right. Obviously, we have to take the advantages that we have, knowing the information that we have, and the people that come forward that are interested in acquiring a team, and then how do we do that to where it makes sense for everybody?
What options, though, does this? It seems as though you look at this deal, and one of the reasons that I think you and other members of the new council weren't too happy about it was it's a pretty sweetheart deal for this new ownership group. If you can't get an ownership group assembled with that kind of deal, where do you go from here?
Well, and I've already started going from there. I actually talked with the NHL commissioner yesterday, even though it was Sunday. Apologized to him for me calling him on Sunday, and he informed me that his job is a 365-day-a-year job, I guess, as mine is. But, the problems don't go away. They don't change. And so it's up to me to do everything in my power to try to make things work. And I offered to him myself as far as doing whatever we can to try to negotiate something that will allow him to find more buyers. We've already got two folks that unfortunately right now I can't divulge who they are, that have expressed some major interest. One of those I'm very confident has the ability, but again, in business, they're only gonna do what makes sense for them. So it's finding that balance for the businesses and for the city.
I think some Coyotes fans would say, hey, wait a second, we got a couple folks out here waiting to get in, and we had a group here waiting to find some friends. Why couldn't the two meet?
Well, again, businesses, not necessarily all businesses are going to want a partner. And I think one of the issues previously is I think that as Mr. Jamison kept going to different lenders, by the time you split that pie in so many different pieces, no one's getting a whole lot, but everybody is susceptible to a lot of downside. Mm-hmm. So if you can't reap the most rewards and you stand to lose, sometimes that's not very appealing.
Too much risk.
Potentially, yes.
What would you like to see the city do?
Well, we're already doing that. Obviously, I've already talked with Mr. Jamison. I've talked with a couple different folks that have expressed interest. I say Mr. Jameson, the NHL commissioner. Yesterday in the conversation we had, he was extremely excited on something that I had suggested, and he said that previously they didn't have those options that I'm suggesting that we at least talk about today.
What would that be?
I wished I could tell you, but you know, right now I have to protect potential investors, and the main thing is we have to have some negotiations. We have to open it up to as many people as possible, not limit ourselves to just one buyer. That whole open process as far as getting as many people involved as possible to try to get the best deal for the city. Once we come up with something, then we can present it, and then, of course, the public will know about it. But it has to work. It just has to work for the city.
And I know you didn't think the last deal necessarily would work the best for the city. Why is that? And again, can you reshape, restructure something that would be attractive to investors, especially when investors weren't all that attracted to what was offered before?
I do think so. And again, our conversation yesterday, what I suggested to him, he was very excited about. And it is changing the contract, some details about it that actually wouldn't cost the city as much money, but potentially the new owners have more opportunities. And that's huge. You know, business is all about opportunities. The least amount of gamble for the most amount of profit made is what businesses are always looking for.
So you disagreed with the last deal. What was it in general or in particular that you didn't like about that last deal?
There were several things. What I had talked about in my campaign all along is, you know, if you're a citizen and your house catches on fire, if you have someone breaking into your house and you need to call public safety, the deal that we had with the hockey is it had the appearance to most citizens that we're going to go ahead and fund hockey at all costs. And that's not necessarily true, but that was perception. At the same time, we're coming back and we're cutting public safety. So one of the things I mentioned and said several times in my campaign is if you need a fireman or a policeman to show up at your house quickly, you don't want somebody showing up in a Zamboni. You want somebody showing up that obviously is showing up to do that job.
Were there not separate silos, though, one for Coyotes, one for city services and such? Could they not have existed side by side?
Again, it comes down to perception. You know, as you're giving money away to a National Hockey League, at the same time, at the very, very same time, you're cutting your public safety. Citizens don't care. They don't care whether they're different silos or not. The perception is you're going to fund this and cut this.
Can the city afford to have the Coyotes leave? Can you afford to have that arena without a tenant, a hockey tenant?
I think that if we can't get a deal that makes sense, we may not have any options, although we're trying desperately right now to come up with a balance that can accomplish both the city not losing a lot of money, making more than it spends, and at the same time giving the team coming in an opportunity to build, become successful, draw more attendance, and hopefully in years to come be able to fill that arena.
Do you think that the arena so far and the hockey team so far in that arena, have they both been a catalyst for growth out there?
I think early on before the recession hit, I think it was huge. When you go out to that area now, you see a lot of closed businesses. And the real question is, are the hockey games that are being played, are they drawn in enough to keep those businesses open? I went out before the election and talked with several merchants. Several merchants said, our doors aren't open because of the hockey. They help. It certainly doesn't hurt. But if we depended only on hockey, we couldn't make it. So when Tanger Outlets just opened up, which is a huge, huge boom to our city, those type of things is what's going to grow. You know, we have a new hospital that we just had a ceremony 2 days ago, St. Joseph Westgate, which I've coined the name Joe West. You know, we got some huge growth coming into our city, along that corridor 101 Glendale Avenue, and our city is a place where in the future is where things are going to be happening. That's where the money's going to be coming, and I think that we can salvage all this.
Do you have a plan B, C, or D in place if the team does leave?
Right now we are in discussions with potential owners. This is so fresh that the council hasn't had a chance to sit down. Obviously, I'm one vote of seven. Mm-hmm. I have to get other members figure out what they want to do, how they want to accomplish that, and hopefully we can get on the same page and address the city's needs. That's bottom line. That's what we have to do.
Last question. Big picture here. Do you think the city should have gotten involved in sports to the extent it has between the Cardinal Stadium, University of Phoenix Stadium, Jobbing.com Arena, Camelback Ranch. There's a lot of big-time sports activity out there. You hear criticism all the time that no one wants to go out to Glendale, no one wants to do this, it's too far away. But has it been worth it?
Loaded question. When things are cooking, when things are working right, when the economy's good, I think it's great for the city. The real question with our economy today, I don't think the driving has anything to do with it. I think people do what they want to do when they want to do it. You know, you look at the Renaissance Festival over on the far east side, Superstition Mountain area. I know a lot of people from the West Valley that drive that. They do that because they want to do it. So the drives don't make that much difference. It's when you have somebody that has season tickets to something that's being played two or three times a week. That's where it becomes difficult, especially on school nights if they have kids.
Yeah.
So, you know, yeah, it might be hard for people in Scottsdale, but the people in the West Valley, Avondale, Surprise, El Mirage, Buckeye, Goodyear, Litchfield Park, all those folks, no, I don't think they mind the drive at all.
All right. All right. Mayor, it's good to have you here. Thanks for joining us. We appreciate it.
You bet. Thank you.